Peeps, hello and welcome back. Today we're going to be talking about OBS filter order, specifically filter order as it pertains to video and audio. We're going to have two different examples here to show you how you can use different filters to affect things differently across your OBS. So let's go ahead and get started right into it, starting with the video filter orders. Right now I have another OBS opened up just so you can see some examples with this. And I just have an image here of my friend Norton and I. We did some Take-Two stuff a while back. And I'm going to show you a few different examples of how filters and filter order can matter in trying to achieve different results. So let's go ahead and go into this image and go to filters. Now, one of the things I know that I want to do with this is I want to apply some type of a crop as well as a rounded border to this thing. So up here, I already kind of have some of these pre-selected. I have a corner rounder, a crop, and then a scroll. And I'll kind of show you how these can change and differ and react differently to this. So to start with, I said I wanted a rounded corner for these edges. I'm going to go ahead and turn this on. After turning on that filter, we can now see on this image that we have different corner radii across the entire image here. And that is done by just sitting in here. One's at 100, 200, 300, 400, right? So this is telling us that this is the radius for each of these corners. And I've applied it this way. Well, I want to make it a little bit smaller, right? I don't actually need it Takes Two. Everyone kind of knows what this is. So I want to crop it down so it's more focused on Norton and myself. Well, I'll go ahead and apply this crop here. But when I apply the crop, my corner radius went away. So what's going on here? Okay, so let's go back into the corner rounder. Let's take this 400 one. Let's make this 500 now. Here you can see that this left-hand corner is starting to come in. Well, what the heck's going on? Let's do 600. Okay, I can see it here, but what's happening? If I turn off the crop, we can see that it's still applying the correct thing. But what's happening is the crop filter is applying the crop specifically to whatever is left over after the first filter. So if I apply this crop here, it's gonna take this whole image and apply the crop uniformly across it. Now, if I use the crop first, then the corner rounder, now I have the effect that I was originally trying to achieve, which is the smaller image, more focused in on Norton and myself, as well as now I have the correct corner roundings that I was originally looking for. So I'll go ahead and actually redo that 600 to 400 on the corner round. And there we go. So now I have this here, the correct order that I want it to, but now I want this to scroll because they look really cool, like a banner that's scrolling across my screen. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the scroll filter. All right, cool, it's scrolling across, but as you can see here, the scroll is actually taking even the crop section and moving it all the way across. This is kind of a weird thing to see. Could be the effect that you're looking for, but it's not the effect that I'm looking for. I want this scroll to actually happen above this corner rounder, this way that the image actually scrolls inside of this new border that I have given this here. Now that the corners aren't moving with it, this is kind of the effect that I wanted to, right? So you could actually crop this into any shape that you wanted, right? Using this crop here, or an even more advanced technique, which is using the image mask blend. You could do like a star or a gear or whatever type of maybe channel icon that you have, right? You can use these type of things to create different effects. We know that the scroll is second right now, but what happens if I put it above the crop? If I put it above the crop, you can actually see here, like at Norton's hand or even my hand here, as I turn this scroll down and up, you can actually see like my hand disappears here, right, on this left-hand side. Or if we look over at Norton's hand as his comes through here, as I change where this crop sits, it actually changes what's inside of this banner. For me, I want it more like this so that it's kind of scaled into what I originally wanted it to. So this is why I talk about that the filter effects and how you order them really matter for achieving the different effects that you can do in here. None of them are necessarily wrong, but just bear that in mind that you, well, can change them to be whatever you want it to do. Now let's talk about audio. Audio filter order is arguably a little bit more important than the video filter because you can still achieve whatever effect you want with video. But with audio, if you do things in the wrong order, you can kind of screw up your audio sound. So let's go ahead and take a look at some audio examples. As a rule of thumb, generally audio filter effect order should kind of look something a little bit like this. You want to start with your noise removal, then go into subtractive EQs, compression, whether that's multiband or single compressor or both, then go into your additive EQs, then your vocal effects, so like de-essers or other types of vocal effects, then usually downward expanders or noise gates, whichever you prefer, and then finally like a loudness maximizer, limiter, however you want to phrase that. I use something that has both of those actually combined into one. So this is kind of the order that you want to look for. Now, you don't have to follow this order to a T. It's just a general rule of thumb is all. You're starting at the top, you're trying to remove different things from your audio signal that you don't want, right? Like I don't want noise in my signal. I don't want like really harsh sibilance or other things in my signal as well. So those things I try to pull out as soon as possible. So that way my different compressors don't basically start compressing on bad signals. Then from there, I'll add in a little bit of stuff that I think that I might be missing. And then you kind of just start adding a little bit of sparkle at the end. It's kind of the sprinkles on top, right? With like de-essers or otherwise, those are just kind of little sprinkles over top. So let's take a look at some effects of this and how this can actually matter. So for audio, let's go ahead and take a quick listen to just a short snippet of an unfiltered, no audio effects, little file here.
You've been on the Tribor Trail for about 3.5 days. As you round the bend into your...
So as of right now, that is completely unaltered signal. But what I want to do with this, right, is kind of show you that the effects actually matter. So let's go ahead and go into the audio filters. I'm going to go ahead and add in, I'm just going to add in a compressor. I'm just going to use a Reaper compressor. So I'm going to use a VST. It's going to help us visualize this a little bit. I'm then also going to add in a gain filter. Then finally, I'm going to go ahead and add in a limiter filter. And the one that I actually use is something called Loudmax 64, something that I love using. It's always been incredibly useful. And that's the one I'm going to kind of show off here just to show some of the differences. Other thing to note here real quick is right now I do actually have the compressor, gain, and limiter in like the correct order, and then I'm going to show you how to set this up, and then I'm going to show you what happens if I don't set it up in this exact same way. So setting up my compressor, I'm making sure that my threshold is just at like where the peaks are getting dropped down. So if I go ahead and play this here, so if you look over here, this little red line that's sitting up here, this is actually what it's basically compressing down. And I want it to just be licking at the top of these things when I'm getting loud without being overbearing and just constantly damping the entire signal. So that's kind of what I'm looking for with this. With the compressor applied, it's going to make everything quieter, right? Because we're basically taking the loud stuff and making it quieter. So we're going to go ahead and apply a gain of, I don't know, let's say like 14 decibels for the moment, and let's see what this comes out.
You've been on the Tribor Trail for about 3.5 days. As you round the bend into your final corner, as you know, is this head.
So as of right now, I'm basically going into about a -2, -3 decibel range, which is actually pretty good because this means it's loud, everybody can hear it, and it's actually a good point for your audience here with that 14 decibel gain. Now, what would happen if I had the gain before the compressor? Well, remember, when this first plays through, all I'm doing is tamping down those very loud moments, right? Let's go ahead and move the gain before the compressor here and listen to that exact same signal.
You've been on the Tribor Trail for about 3.5.
I hope you saw what I saw already right off the bat. That red is all the way down here into like this 12, 14, 15, 16 decibel range here, right? That means that signal that's going in is getting compressed down so much. And that's because we applied a 14 decibel gain beforehand. Now, yes, I know what some people are going to say is, well, then you could apply a different compressor threshold to this. And you are correct with that. And this is a way to do it, which is why I said, these are not hard and fast rules. You just have to be mindful the way that things are working, right? So I could still put gain into it, right? Make sure everything's up there, make sure it's only pulling it down. And then I can apply a second gain. But when you start doing this, all the noise in your signal, all the quiet stuff that should stay quiet, it's gonna get louder and louder and louder. So let's go ahead and take a listen to this. If I do a gain into my compressor and then I'm like, wow, it's still really quiet. And then you need a second gain. So let's listen to that.
Check, check, 1, 2, 1, 2. I'm seeming to be coming in. You've been on the Tribor Trail for about 3.5 days.
Already right off the bat, I can hear that it's super compressed. And right at the beginning here, you can actually hear what I think is like some TV noise and some dishes in the background here. So listen. Right at the beginning part, right? So this is why I talk about, like, sometimes you're like, man, why is my signal so quiet? You might be trying to add gain to your signal and not realizing that you have it before some type of a compressor or other thing that's making everything quieter. And then you're like, well, I need the second one. But now I'm constantly fighting, like, all I can hear are the clicks on my keyboard and the clicks on my mouse. And it's because you're going through basically two huge gain stages. So that's why typically I try to do this so that I can do all of my gain at one shot without having to accidentally have multiple gains in other spots. So if you've been watching some audio guides, you're like, oh man, I love how they added this effect in here. And then you just add it at the end of your signal chain. You could be doing yourself a disservice by adding whatever that thing is right at the end. It might be better placed further up that effect chain instead of right at the end. Because remember, OBS applies filters in the order that they're here. So whatever the first one is applied, then the second one takes the signal from the first one and then applies it to that. So just be mindful that your effect orders do matter for both video and audio. So I hope this video helped you understand the importance of your effect filter order. And if you have any questions, please let me know down below. Otherwise, I hope you all have a great day and I'll see you all in the next one. Till then, take care. Love ya. Bye.